Hey, what's going on? Matthew here with Madcapper Marketing. And a question that I get asked a lot, how do I get my Zoom recordings to be automatically saved into my Dropbox so that I don't have to remember to go into Zoom, download them, delete them, put them into my Dropbox because Zoom just wants to charge me a bunch of money to store my videos there and I just don't need to do that.
He always saying like as if it was too expensive.
I have a Dropbox account. I suggest storing media on Dropbox. Much better than Google Drive or pCloud or even your local computer because Dropbox can go in the cloud and you can have it stored in your cloud or on the computer or in the cloud only, not taking up space. I'm not gonna get too much into that today, but I'm gonna answer the question. So I'm gonna jump onto my computer and knock that out right now. So the first thing you wanna do is jump into your Zoom login area, go to your recording section, which is going to be over here on the left-hand side. You're going to want to kind of check out what your settings are. Right now it says cloud recordings will be deleted after they have been stored for 3 days. Most people by default have this set to 30 days. I would suggest making that shorter if you do a lot of Zoom recordings, which everyone seems to be doing that these days. As you can see here, I've had two or three just today. Pop on over here into the settings, which is going to be on your right-hand side, or your advanced settings, which will be down here. I'm just gonna use this quick link right here. And then you're gonna scroll down, and I just want you to have a couple things automatically ticked off. I like to have all of these ticked off. Some people like to have only active speaker, but I like having the flexibility in case I need to have just the audio or just the gallery view or just the screen share. I want just the audio. So this gives me, as a content creator, much more flexibility in the editing room. I don't like having the timestamp on there. Let's just scroll down here a little more. And this is the part I want to show you. I have it automatically delete after 3 days. So you can go ahead and knock that out for you. Now what I want to show you is the setting inside of Dropbox, okay? So you are going to have to go into your Dropbox. So here I am in my Dropbox. Come on over here to the right-hand side on this side. You're going to want to click on your setting. As you can see, I've got 2.14 terabytes of storage. I'm only using 1.4, so I've got plenty of room left, and you can upgrade that pretty easily. You're going to want to go to settings, and you're going to want to go to connected apps. You're going to want to connect your Zoom right there. And as you can see here, edit settings, click on that. You want to make sure that this is selected. Zoom settings, copy Zoom cloud recordings to Dropbox. After a meeting you host is recorded to Zoom cloud, the recording will be copied from Zoom cloud to your Zoom folder. We'll notify you, okay? So you want to make sure that is clicked. That's the magic button right there. This, what I just showed you. So inside of Zoom, just in case, you also have an integration section right here under the advanced tab. You're going to want to make sure that your Dropbox is connected to your Zoom at this level. But between those two integrations and connecting yourself at the Dropbox level under connected apps, you're gonna have your recordings automatically go there. So let's do a quick test demonstration to show you how you do it. So I'm gonna open up my Zoom. I'm gonna pop it over here. I'm gonna create a new meeting. I'm gonna join audio. I'm gonna hit record. I'm gonna hit record in the cloud. And I'm gonna say right now is 6:01 p.m. on October 22nd. So that's a nice short video. I'm gonna go ahead and end this Zoom meeting, okay? Now I'm gonna come over here into my Gmail and I wanna get an alert from Dropbox. So I'm gonna do a quick search for Dropbox. Let's pop into Zoom just to make sure that that recording is in there. Go to recordings. As you can see, it's processing still right there. So as soon as that's done processing, Dropbox will automatically send an email to my Gmail alerting me that my recording is done, and it will automatically go to my Dropbox. So let's see if that happened yet. Okay, so now as you can see, I just got an email alert from Dropbox saying that my recording is done. So that's really great, right? So now let's pop on over to the folder in my desktop. As you can see here, it does have the recording right there. I'm gonna go ahead and save it to the local level so that I can open it up and show you that it actually is the recording that I just took and it automatically went to my Dropbox. And I'm gonna say right now is 6:01 p.m. on October 22nd. There you go. So literally within a minute or two, it automatically went from the Zoom recording to my Dropbox, gave me an email alert, and now I don't have to worry about it because it's with all the rest of my Zoom recordings for archiving for the future. A quick tip over here is if you can see my screen, you can do a right click, go to Smart Sync, and you can store them online only or locally. So for this file, it's rather large. I'm going to want to store it online only because it's a gigabyte. So now I've just cleared up 1 gig of space on my local computer. That's a quick tip. So thanks so much for watching that recording where I'm actually going to save you time and me time automating the process of saving my Zoom recordings to the Dropbox automatically, so you always know where they are and you never have to end up paying for more space, and you always have a recording and a backup of them. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and subscribe and continue watching some of our other videos as well. This is Matthew with Mad Capper Marketing. Thanks a lot. See you on our next video.